transportation. Got me feeling over anxious like a home invasion. I don't inflate it and I'm more creative. Take a couple big deals, but it's no parade. Here's a couple, every generation. I wasn't supposed to make it out, but decode the matrix. When they get to speak, it's like a coded language. Reminds me of their strength and all the stolen greatness. We was ready at the mobile station. Or serve a mobile motivation. My self-educated through negotiations. Got these shorts that I'm sitting at this table with a faded baby. No telling my Mercedes, that's for inspiration. 2 kilos on my neck like the Knights. Well, sign starts now, I know my demonstration. Or the brains try to affiliate. It's really greatness.
Should I really even start? I got that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my across the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead. Thought my raps were the facts, so they sat with the bars. I got 2 phones, 1 need a charge. Yeah, they twins, I can tell they pick apart. I got big packs coming on the way. I got big stacks coming out to save. I got Lil Max with me, he the way. It's a big gap between us and the game. In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid. When I die, I put my money in the grave. When I die, I put my money in the grave. I really gotta put a couple in their place. Really just lap every in a ways. I really might tap realest on my face. Lil CC, let it slap with the bass. I used to say, put a mask in a cave. Now I'm like, nah, love, I'm good, go away. Ain't about to die with no money out in gave. I was on top when it meant a lot. Still on top, like I'm scared of the drop. Still on top, these wanna swap. Wanna swap like a sauce in a watch. I don't wanna change cause I'm good where I'm at. Multi, so I'm always good where I'm at. Word of Junior, Jazzy, Baby J. Tell him when I die, put my money in a crate.
Couple figures, kill a skull, intellect. And she on to the next. Really living large, she ain't all with a Mac. When you think it's small in the mall with a rat. Roll with us if you really wanna get it. Go get a half a million in the Sprinter. Phone ringing, no a big tipper. I got the other than there really no limit. Dead burgers in you, DNA. Ricky Smiley's indicated with it. Look, just another state case. Bury my mother, Chase Bank, trying to bounce. Gotta count on my allowance. You, get you so I gotta make it.
Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Lambton Lions Men's Basketball. Making sure we're not going out over the PA.
We good?
All right. Good news. All right. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another exciting edition of Lambton Lions Men's Basketball, back for another season. I'm Tony Frangis, live from the Lions Den. We're going to go down to courtside for the starting lineup with public address announcer Dave Walls.
Assistant coach in his first year, Joe Spadafora. John Spadafora
Paul Doyle and Keith Consism, assistant coaches. James Grant in his 12th year, head coach of the Lions. Tip-off is next.
Well, as we're just a few seconds away from tip-off, I will tell you the mood here at the Lions Den is electric, and there is an air of confidence that we have never seen on this court before for the Lambton Lions. The squeak in and make the playoffs as the sixth seed is no longer good enough. You talk to the coaching staff, you talk to the players, and the mantra is simple: get out there and win. This is an historic season for the Lambton Lions as they have been granted an automatic bid into the OCAA Provincial Championship this coming March here in Sarnia, hosted at the Lions Den. So they get an automatic bid into the playoffs. However, the goal night after night is to go out and win and improve on last year's 10-10 record. Off to a good defensive start for the Lambton Lions. Here comes Cardin Edwards bringing it up past half court, handing it off to Cam David. Highly touted rookie, as Cardin Edwards will miss the three. DeAndre Reed pulling down the O board, and another shot clock is granted for the Lions. Tyvel Peters working his way through a few defenders. Shot is just off the mark. It is Knight's ball. Niagara Knights coming off a very impressive season of their own, 15-5 last year, as the three is good for starter number one, Laquan Hilton. The senior, the 5'10", fifth-year guard out of Mississauga, Ontario, putting the first bit of offense up on the board this evening. Cam David looking to drive. The lane is closed for him. He fakes three, goes baseline, the handoff to Jason Watts, mishandled, and back into the hands of the Niagara Knights. Got to give a big congratulations to the Lambton Lions women's basketball team, who just a few minutes before this game started wrapped up theirs, a resounding 89-43 victory over the Niagara Knights women's team here to start their season off on the right foot. To the line will go Raheem Barty, number 7, the second year 6'4" forward out of St. Catharines. Lions fans very quick to make some noise here in the den. Does not affect Barty at all. He's on the board. Some more fans getting in on the action. A little louder on this second shot. However, Barty will go 2-for-2 from the line, and the Knights are off to a 5-0 run in the first minute 15 of this very young season here. Cardin Edwards bringing it past half court. Tyvel Peters finds DeAndre Reed. Reed pulls up, handoff back to Tyvel Peters. He goes cross court to Cardin Edwards. Edwards finds it open. Jason Watts, he looks for the tray, nails it. Jason Watts, 15 points per game last year to go along with a pair of blocks, 7.5 rebounds as well. Hitting the three from the top of the key. However, his favorite spot is that corner. Look for him at that spot as Cameron David brings it back the other way for the Lions. Mishandled by Peters and out of bounds. Definitely a size advantage in favor of the Niagara Knights this evening, as two of their starters, pardon me, just one of them, Kevin Cooper, coming in at 6'8". Also Simfu Alunga at 6'8" on the bench as well, out of Welland, the rookie. And look out for the fourth year forward, Donald Mims, 7 feet tall. The only player on the court this evening to break the 7-foot mark. DeAndre Reed pulling down the rebound. Back come the Lions. Jason Watts looking for the long two. Not quite, gets his own rebound though. Showing a bit of that truculence there. Jason Watts not afraid to throw a few elbows around and get those rebounds. Cardin Edwards will inbound it for the Lions. He's going to go all the way out to Cam David, looking for the long three. He's looking to impress early. That one just off the mark. And back comes Niagara. That is number 33 out near the free throw line, Jordan McDonald, as number one, Laquan Hilton, will hit it from the corner. They gesture three. It is now 8-3 in favor of the Niagara Knights, 7:20 to go here in the opening frame. Cam David looks to find an open man to Tyvel Peters, out to Cardin Edwards in the corner. That shot won't go either. Offense off to a cold start for the Lambton Lions, but this is a young season, impressed very much in the preseason, virtually undefeated the entire way. Good defensive effort, and it's in favor of the Lions. Edwards will inbound to Cam David, the rookie out of Brampton, Ontario, 5'11". 1 of 10 players for the Lambton Lions on their roster in their first year of OCAA eligibility. Tries to go to the baseline there to Kevin Cooper. Pass is intercepted. Back comes DeAndre Reed looking to go coast to coast. Not quite, but Jason Watts there for the putback. Trying to ignite that Lions offense early here. 6:20 to go. It's 8-5 in favor of the Niagara Knights. As Laquan Hilton looking for the long three. He won't get it. Jordan McDonald gathers it, though. He'll go to the line for a pair. DeAndre Reed will get charged with his first foul of the game. Nobody checking in over at the scorekeeper's table, so both sides will remain with their starting five early on. The fans even louder this time as perhaps that effort worked. Jordan McDonald missing his first free throw. Fifth year forward, 6'3" out of Mississauga. One of their more reliable shooters and misses both of them. And here we go. Maybe this will wake up the crowd a little bit more. Carden Edwards weighing his options. He will drive. That one is off the mark. Back come the Niagara Knights. McDonald with the handoff to Kevin Cooper. He is fouled on the way. And here comes another highly anticipated debut. We have been waiting for Darius Canty. We'll check into the game as DeAndre Reed will take a seat. Welcome to the Lambton Lions. Darius Canty, number 12. You see him lining up as Cooper's first free throw is short. In this contest, you can imagine the Lions will rely heavily on the size of Darius Canty, as this is a rather large roster the Niagara Knights bring with them. So far, holding their own. Cam David across court to Carden Edwards. Tyvell Peters handing it off to Jason Watts now. Watts to Canty. Darius Canty looking to split the defenders. Finds its way out to Tyvell Peters. He's taking three and it rattles in. Peters on the board, usually a sure bet from the field, shooting almost 50% last year, almost 40% from three. And the team's leading scorer last year, 21.5 points per game. Watts over to Darius Canty. Canty will drive. Tries to go up and under, not quite. And back come the Knights here on the 5-on-1. As Laquan Hilton hits the... They're going to rule that as a long two. No, they will rule it as a three. The Lions aren't going to take a quick timeout here. 4:55 to go. Brief conversation over at the Lions bench. Not overly animated so far. It is the first quarter after all, but perhaps going over some of those defensive cues, a little bit of a lapse there, particularly on that last play. However, the game is obviously far from over. We're halfway through the first quarter. 13-8, the Niagara Knights lead the Lambton Lions here in opening night of the OCAA men's basketball and women's basketball season as well. One more time, want to congratulate them on their big win today. 89-43, the Lambton Lions women's basketball team victorious over the visiting women's Niagara Knights from about half an hour ago or so. Up next for the Lions tomorrow, back here on home court, the Mountaineers out of Mohawk College will pay a visit. Women tip off around 1 o'clock. The men will tip off closer to 3. Thank you to those watching this evening as well at lclions.ca/live. As you can see, kind of a new and improved production that we have here, and we thank those who are staffing it and volunteering it. A lot of work went into it over the last several months, and we're certainly glad to have them here as part of the team up in the booth as Journey Joseph has entered the game for the Lambton Lions. 4:50 to go. Carden Edwards will bring it past half court. Back over to Journey Joseph. As Tyvel Peters looks to drive. I'm going to say he was fouled on the way. He will set up at the line. Tyvel Peters with an absolute breakout season last year, 21.5 points per game. And if there was an OCAA award for most improved player, it is his, without a doubt. Can practically hear a pin drop as he shoots those, misses the second one. Bringing the deficit for the Lions down to 4. Jordan McDonald back it up to Darius Canty. Can't get around him. He's going to hand it off to, that is number 3, Johnny Richardson. And the 3 will miss for Raheem Barty. Back come the Lions. Journey Joseph now. They're going to roll out of bounds. It is Lions ball. Journey Joseph, some of the best footwork in the OCAA. The guy can run sideways as fast as some people can run facing straight forward. Really a sight to behold, and that's what gives him so much defensive prowess. Welcome to the OCAA, Darius Canty, as he finds his way into the paint. His first points as a Lambton Lion. The first of many to come, I'm sure. Barty trying to float one in. It won't go. Back come the Lions here. Tyvel Peters looking to drive. Looks like they're going to call that for him going on the way up. He's going to the line for 2. Entering the contest now for the Lions, Dinesh Hegedus, number 13, and look for number 11 as well, Malik Akumba out of Ottawa. First free throw for Peters is good. Journey Joseph will take a seat for now. Oh, perhaps not. Nope, just getting a quick drink. He's fine. Second one from Peters. Rattles out. He shakes his head on the way back to play defense there. He knows he kind of missed the mark there. He'll find his groove. The season is young, like we keep saying. As the putback for Jordan McDonald is good for a pair. Knights maintaining a 3-point lead over the Lambton Lions. 3:18 to go here on the opening frame. Tyvel Peters over to Dinesh. He'll drive, floats it in, no problem. And off the glass for 2. That's good for Jordan McDonald of the Niagara Knights. Journey Joseph now weighing his options. Back over to Hegedus. Looking for the long 2. He gets it, but a foot inside. Weighing his options now, Laquan Hilton. Stolen by Darius Canty. There's that defensive prowess that got him the gig here with the Lambton Lions in the corner. Is Malik back out to Tyvel Peters? Can't quite finish it off. Canty fighting for it, but finds its way back outside. Here come the Knights. McDonald inside to Barty. And the deficit back to 3 for the Lions. Here they come again, Tyvel Peters. And that is Malik looking for 3. No for Akumba. A And looking to answer is Laquan Hilton. He'll miss as well. Back come the Lambton Lions, and they're taking it slow. You can see there's no sense of panic just yet. They know the game is young. A minute 40 left here in the opening quarter. Looks like he took a hand to the face there. He is going to go to the line for two. And I'm not sure where the shoulder shrug from Laquan Hilton is coming from. That foul was as clear as day. And both teams will get some sets of fresh legs in. Jason Watts will re-enter the game. Canty and Akumba will take a seat for the Lions. And in comes Tyrell Miller. As Joseph hits his first free throw entering the game for the Niagara Knights, one to look out for. Like we talked about, Donald Mims, the fourth year forward out of Sacramento, California, the only 7-footer on the court. As the second one rattles out for Joseph. Kasamba across the court. And way too much on that one for number 11, Deshaun Thompson. Journey Joseph to Jason Watts, awaiting at the free throw line. The jumper's good for a pair. Tyrell Miller for the Lambton Lions, seeing his first action. That's number two, wearing the headband there. And the wide open three is air for number three, Johnny Richardson. However, the putback is good for two for the Knights. And they restore a two-point lead. 45 seconds to go. As Tyvel Peters calling over to Jason Watts. Now in his hands, Journey Joseph has it. Watts looking for the open three. He'll go for it. Nails it. Lions taking their first lead here, 22-21, about 25 seconds to go. And an 8-second violation on the Niagara Knights. It is Lions ball. And I think that was the spark they were looking for, that last 15-second sequence there. The bench a little louder, the fans just a little louder now, and I think a little more confidence we were waiting to see from the Lions. A little bit of discussion amongst the officiating staff. Back at it here. 17 seconds to go. Shot clock is down to six. It's Tyvel Peters looking for the foul there. I think he should have got it, to be honest, but on we go. Here we go, down to 7 seconds. Calling for it is Donald Mims, but nothing. And visible frustration for him. As the first quarter comes to a close and the Lambton Lions are on the right side of the scoreboard here, 22-21 over the Niagara Knights. Back in about 2 minutes here with second quarter action. Second quarter action underway here at the Lions Den. 22-21, the Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights. Cam David back on the floor for Lambton. Jason Watts, Dinesh Hegedus, Journey Joseph, and the debut of Tyrell Miller. As the three from Hegedus will miss, Cam David showing some muscle and pulling down the O-board, and another 14 seconds on the shot clock for them. Shot clock down to three. Watts fighting for it, but he is stripped, and back come Johnny Richardson and the Niagara Knights. That's where things differ a little bit in the OCAA compared to other basketball, such as the NBA. If you do get an offensive rebound, you don't get a completely fresh shot clock. You get a reduced one of sorts. 14 seconds. Journey Joseph with a good fake handoff to Dinesh, and that is good for two. From Joseph. Coming in from Hungary to join us this season again. Lions lead extends to three. And here we go. Hilton looking to tie things up again. That won't go. Watts pulling it down, and back come Journey Joseph and the Lambton Lions. Cam David now with it. Pulls up, looking for the long two. Won't go. Pulled down by number seven, Raheem Barty. Back come the Knights again. That is Johnny Richardson, number three. Looking to do a little bit of everything there. The finger roll, no good. They're going to say last touched by the Lions. Carden Edwards will re-enter the game. Journey Joseph will sit for now. Carden Edwards, one of the better scorers for the Lambton Lions last year as well. 14 points per game. Absolutely excels at the free throw line. 89.2% last year as Watts will miss the three. Edwards leading the team in assists as well last year as Jason Watts with the strip, and back come the Lions. Cam David goes baseline, tried to get a little fancy and go behind the back to Carden Edwards. Out of bounds off the Knights, it is Lions ball. Back into the game is Darius Canty out of nearby Ecorse, Michigan. And a quick hello to the Canty family if they are watching this stream this evening. Certainly hope they are, and we're certainly glad to have Darius here with the Lambton Lions this year. Richardson couldn't find an opening, and he had to back out. Cooper fighting for it, and there's Darius Canty stripping Kevin Cooper. And back come the Lions again. And a little too much muscle on that pass from Carden Edwards. It'll be Knights ball.
What?
Quick timeout here, 7:32 to go. The Lambton Lions leading the Niagara Knights 24-21 in what has been a relatively low-scoring affair. The Lambton Lions last season averaging exactly 90 points per game. And just want to give a quick hello. We welcome those of you who have been watching the Sarnia State game from Oshawa. We understand there have been some major technical difficulties there. We'll get you back there as soon as we can. My name is Tony Frangis, and we are bringing you OCAA men's basketball action live from the Lions Den on Channel 700. Thanks for joining us, and we'll get you back to that game as soon as we can. Certainly hope to see you here in person as well. Just a reminder, these games are free to attend. The next one, you know what, tomorrow. Come and join us, 3 p.m. The men will tip off, the women tip off at 1, as the Mohawk Mountaineers will be paying a visit for the first and only time. If you're not familiar with OCAA basketball and how it works, basically home and home. One game at home, one game away against each team in your respective conference. 7:32 to go here, 24-21, the Lambton Lions leading the Niagara Knights. And back they come, Laquan Hilton. Bringing it past half court for Niagara. Lang has options here, finds an open Jordan McDonald. The lane closed for him fairly quickly. Darius Canty sticking to him like glue. They're going to call an offensive foul. It is back in the hands of Lambton.
Locally,
On the floor now for the Lions, Tyvell Peters, Carden Edwards, Jason Watts, Darius Canty, and Cam David. That's Carden Edwards, number 21, bringing it past half court. Motioning for Watts to set the pick and roll. Instead, he'll fade. Darius Canty in the corner, guarded by Kevin Cooper. He gets around him. Can't finish it off, though. Hard to get around that long reach of Kevin Cooper, 6'8", out of Nassau, Bahamas, in his fourth year with the Niagara Knights. Hilton with the handoff to McDonald. McDonald backing his way in, splits the defenders, blocked by Jason Watts, and back come the Lions. Tyvell Peters on the fast break, can't finish. No foul call. Peters shaking his head, and back come the Knights, and the pace of play really picking up now. Fighting for it is Johnny Richardson, but can't finish it off, and back come the Knights again. Our kudos to our camera operators for keeping up with that sequence. As Cam David slowing things down, I think much needed for both sides. David tries to find Canty on the baseline, passes a little wide. They're gonna rule that it was tipped, and it is Lions ball. 6:05 to go, still 24-21. Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights. In comes DeAndre Reed as the veteran Jason Watts will take a seat. DeAndre Reed, definitely one of the more outgoing personalities in all of the OCAA, as Cam David looking for the long three, a little short. And here we go again, a fresh 24 for the Niagara Knights. Inching his way in is Laquan Hilton. He'll put it in for two. Trying to get anything going for that Knights offense. It's been about 4 minutes since their last points. Tyvell Peters going across to Cam David. David was looking for Canty down low. And the whistle is blown as the shot clock erroneously looks like it may not have been reset. And the officials are going to deliberate as to how to handle this one exactly. And unfortunately, these things happen, and all you can do is take them with a sense of humor. Luckily, although every regular season game is important, it is a relatively low leverage situation, as it is the season debut after all. No postseason berths on the line just yet, so no reason to get uptight. And it is the second quarter after all, 5:25 to go here. And after their guesstimation, 9 seconds does remain on the shot clock. As Carden Edwards will inbound it to Cam David, number 6. Shot clock is down to 5. A very vocal Lions bench letting them know. Canty to an open Carden Edwards in the corner. It won't go, and back come the Niagara Knights once again. That is Laquan Hilton, the 5'10" senior out of Mississauga. Backing his way in is number 12. That is the 7-foot Donald Mims. Out of bounds it goes. Ball belongs to the Lions. Although home opener relatively quiet here in the crowd, a normally electric Lambton Lions fan base. Can't blame them too much, as the offense has had a hard time to get going on both sides, but there's Darius Canty hitting his first tray as a member of the Lambton Lions. They're going to roll that was a long two. His foot was on the line after all, but he does have that ability. I'd like to see the tape one more time. Back we go. Cam David. Getting a little bit of gentle ribbing here from public address announcer Dave Walsh. Darius Canty once again with certainty, 2 points. We're going to give him 2.5, yes. 4:13 to go, Lions up by 5, 28-23. Like we mentioned, a relatively low-scoring affair, but the offense starting to tick, especially in the favor of Darius Canty and the Lambton Lions. As back they come again, here is Carden Edwards. Led the team in assists last year, just a sliver under 4 per game. Canty finds Peters on the outside, he's looking for 3. That won't go. Fighting for it as Carden Edwards can't quite get a grasp on it, and back come the Knights. David almost pulling off the steal, but there is DeAndre Reed fighting for it, and Donald Mims collecting the loose ball. There's a bump from Reed, a bump from David. And now I think we're starting to see some extracurricular activity here. No whistles, not yet. Both sides are going to have to be careful, otherwise you're going to see those technicals start flying around. Reed calling for the open shot, but Cam David decides to drive. Mims and Reed continuing to go back and forth. Looking like Cam David had a thing or two to say as well. And they are going to wave off the two for Laquan Hilton. Looks like the foul was on Cam David, but well before the shot attempt. Entering the game is veteran Jason Watts, number 42. Journey Joseph as well for the Lambton Lions. Daniel Lacoli entering the game. That is number four for the Niagara Knights. He will inbound. This is number 11, Deshaun Thompson, back on the floor as well for the Knights. 3:03 to go, 30-25. Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights here at the Lions Den in the opening night of both team seasons here as DeAndre Reed pulling down the rebound. With the handoff to Tyvel Peters, they'll slow it down a little bit. Joseph was thinking three for a minute. Decides to think better of it, hands it off to Carnon Edwards. Edwards finds Watts in the paint. There's the one-handed slam to wake up the crowd. Before tonight's game, had an opportunity to chat with Jason Watts, asking how he thought and how he felt going into this season, what he thought of some of the new faces on the team, and he said, we are good, we are ready. All that has to happen now is we get out there and play and show what we're made of, and they are showing that now as they have opened up a 7-point lead. Hoping to extend that is DeAndre Reed, looking for the foul on the way up, won't get it. And trying to get something going here, the Niagara Knights. That is Daniel Lacoli, who misses the three. Jason Watts floats one in as well. And very quick to get back on defense. Minute 40 left here in the opening half, 10 seconds on the shot clock here for Niagara. Johnny Richardson looking for an opening. He finds Hilton, who is open for three. The Knights still in the single digits for the quarter, though. They'd really like to get something going in this last minute 25. However, Lambton slowing down the pace of play. Don't want to give him an opportunity to get back into it. Lacoli wanted it over and back, but won't get the call, but instead, Carden Edwards from long range. Timeout is called. The Lions have opened up a 9-point lead. Nice to see the volume here at the Lions Den increasing a little bit with each point and the lead increasing a little bit more. Invite you here again tomorrow as well. 1 o'clock, the women will tip off. 3 o'clock, the men will tip off against the Mohawk Mountaineers. As for the Niagara Knights, they are on their way to St. Clair College in Windsor tomorrow to wrap up a two-game mini road trip of southwestern Ontario. Grant in the middle of that huddle there, the head coach of the Lambton Lions, wearing the Lou Williams special blazer, always busted out for special occasions, such as opening night. Playoff games, you'll see him wear that blazer. That's when you know it's a truly special occasion. That's what he says, whenever he wears the Lou Williams special, he likes to call it. In his 12th year on the bench for the Lambton Lions, been there for a lot of the highs and lows over the last decade plus. Much all of them, including the bronze medal bid for these Lambton Lions, the only medal in men's basketball school history for them just a few years ago, looking to repeat that performance when they host the tournament here in March, the OCAA Provincial Championship here in Sarnia at the Lions Den. And we certainly hope you'll join us. Those begin on March 4th. Number 7 with a little too much on that one, Raheem Barty for the Niagara Knights. Here come the Lions again. Carden Edwards, the handoff to Jason Watts. Over to Journey Joseph. Joseph back to Watts. And yeah, I think he walked on that one. He's not going to put up too much of a fight. Oh, they're going to call foul. All right, here we go. Lions ball. The Knights were motioning a travel call, and I bought into it. Journey Joseph off the glass for two. 45 to go. The lead is up to 11 here. The Lambton Lions leading the Niagara Knights 39-28. Hilton pulls up. Long two. Good. Deficit back to single digits for Niagara here. Cardin Edwards. Want a quick possession here so they can get last possession. He will drive, and he's going to the line. Outstanding rookie year Cardin Edwards had last year. 14 points per game, 89% from the line. One for one in this one. About a 3 second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. An opportunity for the Lions to get last possession. As Laquan Hilton tries to find his way around Journey Joseph. Journey sticking right to him though. And pulling up is Barty. The three will rattle out. And they are going to rule Lions ball after that exchange. 7 seconds to go. Quick timeout taken. They're going to try and get one more bit of offense in here to try and extend that lead. First half of the second quarter, really kind of difficult offensively for both sides. However, the Lambton Lions have been able to recover. A good rally from Darius Canty about halfway through the quarter. Cardin Edwards continuing things for them. Jason Watts has found his way onto the scoreboard as well, as did Journey Joseph. The Niagara Knights having a tougher time here in this second quarter, held to just 9 points. And I imagine the talk in the locker room at halftime is going to be how to spark the offense a little bit. They are a relatively good defensive team, able to pull down those rebounds. They got to take advantage of those second chance points and those second chance opportunities if they want to get back into this one. And I imagine the talk over on the Lions bench, keep it going. It's as simple as that. They're much more alert now, much more awake. The chemistry starting to form between some of the veteran presences and some of the rookies that have found their way onto this team. All veterans on the court for them right now. Journey Joseph, Tyvel Peters, DeAndre Reed, Cardin Edwards, and Jason Watts. That is Tyvel Peters, number one, who will collect the ball at half court. Letting it roll so as not to let the game clock wind down. Watts from his favorite spot. Last chance for the Knights from half court, and heck of an effort from Kasamba, but it won't fall for him. And at the half, the Lambton Lions have surged to a 12-point lead. It is now 42-30 over the visiting Niagara Knights. Back with second half action in about 15 minutes time. You are watching OCAA men's basketball. Stay with us.
Let's burn the roof, and we'll do. Good form.
And at the half here, it is the Lambton Lions leading the Niagara Knights 42-30 here in the opening half of the opening game of the season here. And this is an historic year for the Lambton Lions as they, for the first time in school history, have been granted the privilege of hosting the OCAA Provincial Championship beginning March 4th as the playoffs to determine the best in the province will take place right here at Lambton College, which means the Lambton Lions are granted an automatic bid into the tournament. However, talking with the coaching staff, talking with the players, they know that, they are aware that in a manner of speaking, their regular season record isn't going to factor in too much into how the playoffs go for them. However, they want to win. It's as simple as that. The hype around this team is real. The Niagara Knights, on the other hand, looking to improve as well. A fantastic season for them last year, going 15-5 during the regular season, losing some key veterans like Van Hutchinson Jr., but Kevin Cooper still on the team, still showing off that size, the 6'8" frame out of Nassau, Bahamas in his fourth year. Always an impact player, but looking at the Lambton Lions side, what an incredible first half it's been. A particular pair of rookies making their debut, Cam David, number 6, look for him, and number 12, Darius Canty, showing off both of their offensive prowess, showing off the muscle as well, throwing those elbows around. What an exciting first half it has been, and that has resulted in a 12-point lead in favor of the Lambton Lions, 42-30. Second half action will get underway shortly here, and we hope you'll join us tomorrow as well as the Mohawk Mountaineers visit the Lambton Lions. The women will tip off at 1 o'clock. The men tipping off at 3 p.m. live here at the Lions Den. Second half action coming up in just a moment. Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights 42-30 in OCAA men's basketball action. We'll be right back.
West side, ain't nobody love me as a broken thing on the trickle, or forgive me if I smoke. back. I get my currency stacks. California's feeling back. Ride, pass by, why you kicking in the rock? I got shot but didn't die. Let him see who's next to try. Did I cry? Hell no. Tears shed. For all my homies in the pen, many fears dead. Still fall. Still fall. Till the day I die. Till the day I die. You can bring your crew. You can bring your man. Shoot me up. Feel bomb.
Second half action about to get underway here between the Lambton Lions and the Niagara Knights. What had been an extremely close affair has kind of exploded into a 12-point lead now for the Lambton Lions as they lead it 42-30. A relatively low-scoring game for both sides. The Lions averaging about 90 points a game last year. And through, I'll tell you, the first half of that second quarter there, things were looking rather bleak for both sides, but a little bit of offensive spark finally started to show up in the waning moments of the first half here, and we hope to see more of that as we head into the second half, as we know they are both very capable of. Keys to the game for the Niagara Knights: take advantage of the size differential. They have the reach advantage here, especially highlighted by fourth-year forward Kevin Cooper, 6'8". Perennial starter there, perennially a threat every night for a double-double, actually, and average a double-double over the course of the season. And then, of course, Donald Mims, who we saw selectively through the first half, 7 foot out of Sacramento, California, in his fourth year of OCAA eligibility as well, here with the Niagara Knights. And the key for the Lambton Lions is just shot selection and not missing the mark. Ball movement, those are the things that are going to help them. Taking advantage of their ability to shoot from long range, because just about everybody who takes the floor for the Lambton Lions has that ability to hit the shot from just about anywhere on the court. As the second half gets underway here, Knights ball, as Johnny Richardson has it, he'll hand it off to Hilton. That is Laquan Hilton, he'll float one in for two. Cam David now, in his first regular season game as a member of the Lambton Lions. Tyvel Peters, looking to float one in. Nice work for him. Averaging 21.5 points per game last year, number one Tyvel Peters led the team, one of the top scorers in all of the OCAA. Hilton was trying to find an opening there. Backing his way in was Barty. And Kevin Cooper missing the mid-range jumper. Cooper able to corral it again. Gets back out to McDonald. Cooper has it, and he goes up and under. One of the more difficult players of the OCAA to defend, and understandably so. As Cam David will hand it off to DeAndre Reed. Reed pulls up, long two, blocked by Cooper. There's that size advantage starting to kick in. And stripped. It's Cam David handing it off to Tyvel Peters. And that'll rattle around a little bit before it finds its way in for two. Another 4 points for him in this second half here in the first minute and a half. Laquan Hilton weighing his options, finds Jordan McDonald, hands it out to a wide open Johnny Richardson looking for three. That'll miss. Kevin Cooper collects the loose ball, and he can't put it back. An opportunity missed for the Knights. Back come the Lambton Lions. That's Cam David, number six. Get used to seeing him. You're going to see a lot of him on the floor this year. DeAndre Reed, handoff to Jason Watts. He'll set up at the line for one. For the next couple of years ahead, this is one of the advantages that the Lambton Lions have, is that with the exception of Jason Watts, everybody else on the roster has at least two remaining years of OCAA eligibility, in some case, up to four. Honestly, you can hear a pin drop whenever the Lambton Lions attempt a free throw. The same cannot be said when the Knights attempt one. Shot won't go for Stefan Augustin, number 22 out of Nassau, Bahamas, in his third year for the Knights. David handing it off to Tyvel Peters. He'll try and split the defenders. He tries to float one in. That is collected by Augustin. Here's Laquan Hilton again. Backs his way out. Back out to Hilton. He looks for three. That'll bounce out, and back come the Lambton Lions. That is Carden Edwards showing some fancy ball handling ability there to DeAndre Reed. Showing off some skills of his own. Finger roll won't go. Here come the Knights again. Hilton. Hand off to Richardson. Richardson looking for the lane. Will draw for a wide open. Laquan Hilton, he hits the tray. He's got 5 points here in the third quarter. Lead at 12 for the Lambton Lions, 49-37. As Tyvel Peters can't hit the short ranger. And although some folks still filing their way in here into the gym for the start of the second half, yeah, noticeably quieter audience here at the Lions Den so far. Stefan Augustin will set up at the line to try and complete the three-point play here. Gonna give a big thank you to Tyler Bennett working in our athletics department here, handing us a stat sheet as we get the second half going. As Carden Edwards will bring it up past half court. Jason Watts across to DeAndre Reed, that's number 22. Back over to Jason Watts. Tyvel Peters has it now, almost stripped. He collects it though. Carden Edwards will think three, but no. Mishandled by the Knights. Jason Watts collecting the loose ball. He'll draw the foul and go to the line once again. Jason Watts currently sitting on 16 points, beating his average from last year of about 15. Usually a sure bet from the free throw line himself. He is good for the first one. Second free throw from Jason Watts is good as well. I'm honestly afraid to say a word while he's attempting those because you can hear a pin drop. Hear a few bits of chatter during those free throws, but that's about it. Foul is called. It will remain Knights ball. That is number three, Johnny Richardson, who is going to inbound it for the Knights. He'll find Laquan Hilton. 16 first half points for him. Leading all Knights scorers. Ball will end up out of bounds. It is Lions ball. And here comes Darius Canty, another highly touted rookie. He'll sub in for DeAndre Reed. Darius Canty, number 12. Expect to see a lot more of him as the season goes on as well. He's got the size, he's got the athleticism, he's got the shooting ability. One of the more complete players you'll see now. All he needs is the experience, and he is going to get that very quickly. Had a very impressive second quarter. Looks like, going to say the foul was before the shot. Knights will set up here once again, trying to spark the offense here. Still held to just 40 points halfway through the third quarter. It is number 22, Stefan Augustin, who will inbound. Jordy Joseph having a little bit of fun in the paint while we wait for the play to set up there, showing off the squeaking ability of those shoes. That very familiar noise that you almost tune out if you watch enough basketball, but Journey Joseph reminding us that that ambient sound is very much alive and well. Definitely a good character to have on the court as well, and one of the better defensive players you will see, as the mop has been requested now, possibly as a result of Journey Joseph. Or perhaps it's what he was calling attention to. So there was some purpose to the notable squeaks from the shoes of Journey Joseph. Like I was saying, one of the better defensive players that they have too. Very well-rounded Journey Joseph. Here we go, back at it. Pass intercepted by Cardin Edwards. He keeps it inbounds. It is Lions ball. Outlet pass to Darius Canty. He will drive. Can't quite finish. Just a little too much on that shot. Canty was looking for the foul there. Didn't get it. And driving is number 22, Stefan Augustin. Screen set for Cardin Edwards. He launches the three, just a little short. Back in the hands of the Knights. Jordan McDonald looking for the long two. That'll rattle in. Tyvel Peters has it now for the Lambton Lions. Tried to set the screen for him. He's going to shoot the three anyway. Nothing but net. For the sure shot, Tyvel Peters. Like we mentioned, one of the best scorers in the OCAA, and he is looking to improve on his 21.5 points per game from last season. Don't be surprised when he does. Out of bounds, it is Lions ball. Once again, 3:52 to go. Checking into the game, Tyrell Miller, number two for the Lambton Lions. Dinesh Hegedus back on the floor, as well as Cardin Edwards and Jason Watts will take a seat. Tyvel Peters trying to work his way around some traffic, and good effort by Miller to keep it in bounds. Dinesh weighing his options as the shot clock is down to eight. He'll look for, well, they're going to gesture long two for Dinesh. Lead back up to 12. 3:27 to go, 56-44. Lambton leading Niagara. Cross court pass to Augustin. He'll look to drive. No foul call, surprisingly. No appeal for one either. As Tyrell Miller, number two, has it. The rookie out of Brampton, Ontario, hands it off to Darius Canty. Canty, we're going to show off that long range. That shot just a little short. And back comes Niagara once again. That's Laquan Hilton bringing it up. He's got it in the paint. And Tyvel Peters with the outlet pass. He gets it. And he's up and in for two. Gotta love the sense of humor on some of the player cards that you see that appear on the Jumbotron here if you come and visit a Lambton Lions game in person. Tyvel Peters' favorite player? Tyvel Peters. As Journey Joseph is fouled on the way up, he will set up at the line for a pair. One of the guys on the team having some fun with those player cards that you'll see on the giant screen here, including Tyler Grievers on the bench, mentioning his favorite player, Lambton Lions alumnus Brendan Padgett. As Journey Joseph will set up at the line for two. First one will rattle in for Joseph. Lead extending to 15 now with 2:20 to go here in the third. Second one no good as the loose ball collected by Daniel Lacoli. He'll bring it past half court. Hand off to Hilton. Hilton finds an opening and he'll roll in for a pair. That's number two, Tyrell Miller, bringing it past half court here for the Lions. Over to Dinesh. Dinesh tries to cross around Kevin Cooper. Darn near impossible to do. Darius Canty trying to muscle his way into the paint. That won't fall for him, and the rebound collected by Cooper. Augustin trying to get a little fancy there, and here comes the two-on-one. Joseph will hang on to the ball, and he'll roll in for two. As the game goes on, you start to see a little more synergy and a little more chemistry with the Lambton Lions. As like we mentioned, a lot of new faces on the team. A mix of the old guard and the new. But things are starting to come together nicely. Checking into the game is Jordan McDonald, number 33 for the Niagara Knights. Taking a seat is Stefan Augustin. Minute 10 to go, 61-46. Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights in OCAA men's basketball action. Hand off to Dinesh, and he'll finish it off. Big thank you to those who are watching at lclions.ca and also on your TV. As we bring you select games throughout the season here, glad to have you along with us. McCauley is called for the foul. It is Lions ball here, 46.8 seconds remaining. Here in the third quarter, Hagedus will hand it off to Tyvel Peters. Not in any real hurry, knowing he's got lots of time to work with. The screen set for him though. Trying to find an opening. Might have found a wet spot on the court there, but still in the hands of the Lions. Journey Joseph has it now, number 7. He'll look to finish it off. There's Darius Canty with those second chance points, those important ones. Offensive rebounds hard to come by when you're playing the Niagara Knights, but Canty was able to find one there as number 4, Daniel Lacoby. Hits one from long range. The deficit cut to 16 for the Knights. Shot clock is off. 5 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Tyrell Miller has it. He'll hang on. Looking for three. No. And that'll do it after three quarters here. The Lambton Lions have extended the lead to 16. It is now 65-49 over the Niagara Knights in OCAA men's basketball action. Fourth quarter coming up in a little bit less than 2 minutes' time. Stay with us. Fourth quarter action underway here at the Lions Den, 65-49. The Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights in OCAA men's basketball action. It is the season debut of an historic season for the Lambton Lions. Like we mentioned, this March have been granted the privilege of hosting the OCAA Men's Basketball Championships. Those begin March 4th. As a result of them being held in Sarnia, the Lambton Lions have been granted an automatic bid as number three, Johnny Richardson, will open the scoring here in the fourth quarter, bringing the deficit for the Knights down to 14. 65-51 now. Lambton Lions have medaled once. Just a few years ago, taking home the bronze medal in the OCAA Men's Championship. And they will look to do much more than that. They feel this is the most complete roster that they have ever put on the court as Kevin Cooper with the putback. Knights on a quick 4-0 run to start the fourth quarter here. A few years ago, the Lions taking home the bronze medal, and they are going for gold this year. They said that is the goal. It is simple as that. Win the whole thing, squeaking in as the sixth seed. Simply not enough. As the finger roll for Richardson won't go. Back come the Lions here. Cam David across to a wide open. Jason Watts looking for the long two. Gets it. Laquan Hilton now finding his way into a mix of defenders here, and he is picked off by Cam David. Back comes Tyvel Peters receiving the outlet pass. Finger roll won't go for him, and he knows that was an error. There's a wide open Daniel Lacoli missing the three. Cardin Edwards slowing down the pace of play now for the Lions, looking to regroup here. Couple of lapses at both ends of the court. They'll look to reset here as they try to protect the lead. Still at 14 points. However, with 7.5 minutes to go here in the contest, a 14-point lead can mean basically nothing, and it can evaporate in a matter of seconds if you're not careful. Air ball from Lacoli. Back come the Lions. Here comes Cam David on the fast break. His lane is cut off. He'll look to spin around Lacoli anyway, and he'll finish it. Cam David, just an absolute supreme athlete for the Lambton Lions. Lacoli trying to muscle his way in. Second chance opportunity there for Jordan McDonald will miss. Here comes Tyvel Peters. Finger roll won't go again, but there's DeAndre Reed. He can't finish either. DeAndre Reed called for the foul, going for that loose ball. It will be Knights ball. Journey Joseph will enter the game. Tyvel Peters will take what we imagine is a short break for the Lions' leading scorer. At least for last season, he was the leading scorer, 21.5 points per game. Laquan Hilton, he's looking for the tray, won't get it. Loose ball collected by Joseph, back in control of the Lions. Edwards looks to drive and hand off to Jason Watts. Gonna say it was last touched by the Knights. And it is Lions ball. Checking into the game, the big man Donald Mims for the Niagara Knights, 7-foot senior out of Sacramento, California. A little bit more deliberation from the officiating staff here, but we are back in action. Journey Joseph has it, tries to feed Jason Watts in the paint, finds a wide open Cardin Edwards in the corner. That'll rattle out DeAndre Reed, pulls down the O-board. Fouled on the way up, and he will set up at the free throw line. Jordan McDonald appealing to the officiating staff, saying, "Where's my foul call?" Or something to that effect, as we imagine, showing some visible frustration. 6'6", DeAndre Reed will hit his first free throw. Thank you. goes 2 for 2 from the line. One of the more vocal players you will see on the court, that is for certain. He's not afraid to trade barbs with the opposing side from time to time, just as long as it keeps him out of the trouble of the technical foul, which has been known to happen, but he has stayed out of trouble so far, which is good to see playing a little more of a disciplined game. See a little bit of heat start to generate on the court as the play gets a little more physical. However, the discipline has remained on both sides, although the emotions are starting to show a little bit more as we get deeper into this fourth quarter. Jordan McDonald setting up at the free throw line here, trying to cut into that 18-point deficit, make it 17 now. And the volume starting to increase here with the Lions fan base, as well as McDonald will miss the second free throw. It is pulled down. Johnny Joseph has it, handing it over to Carden Edwards. Outlet to DeAndre Reed. Reed looks to get around Donald Mims. Looks like a foul, trying to reach in for that ball. It is Lions possession. Joseph will set up at the baseline, number 7. Out to DeAndre Reed. He will drive, handoff to Joseph, who was still hanging out at the baseline. Off the glass, won't go, pulled down by McDonald. Jordan McDonald had the screen set for him. Pick and roll for Donald Mims, won't go. And back come the Lions, slowing it down just a little bit. Cam David bringing it past half court to Jordy Joseph, now to Jason Watts in the corner. Cam David to Joseph. Look at this ball movement, hard to keep up, but just a little too much perhaps. One too many passes, back in the hands of the Niagara Knights. Laquan Hilton to the corner for Daniel Lacoli. He'll rattle it in for 3. 14-point lead for the Lambton Lions. 5:18 remaining in the fourth quarter here. It is 71-57 as Cam David will hand it over to Journey Joseph. Back to David. Looks to get around the defenders. There's Carden Edwards looking to set up in the corner. Instead, he'll go back out to Jason Watts. He says, no doubt about it, it is 3. I think DeAndre Reed had a few words for the opposing side there. Him and Donald Mims have been going at it since they both got on the court at the same time in the first quarter. Journey Joseph saying to DeAndre Reed, holding him back, saying, hold on, we have a lead, leave it alone. And now I think that same conversation is going to happen with head coach James Grant. Despite some jubilation from the crowd, Coach Grant expressing his concern, same with the whole coaching staff, saying to DeAndre Reed, listen, let it go. We are in a good position here with a 14-point lead. No need to take a needless technical foul this late in the game and give the Knights an opportunity to get back into this one. And I think a similar conversation happening over on the Knights bench with Donald Mims. And some continued deliberation here as to perhaps maybe a technical is going to be assessed here. Possession arrow right now in favor of the Knights, as the Trololo song graces its presence here in the Lions' den, as the deliberation continues. You know, we have sing-alongs before the start of the fourth quarter. I'd like to see this song get busted out at one point to see how the crowd attempts that one. In case you haven't been to a Lambton Lions game here in person, another opportunity for you tomorrow as the Mohawk Mountaineers come to town. Women will tip off around 1 o'clock. Men's game will go closer to 3 p.m. T-shirt tosses. You had a shoot for a $1,000 opportunity at halftime. We had a young gentleman on the court here. Basically, the rule is simple. You get 2 attempts at a layup, 2 attempts at a free throw, 2 attempts from 3. And if you hit any of those, or hit one of each, get to attempt a half-court shot for $1,000, and couldn't hit the three-pointer this evening, unfortunately, but we have seen some very close calls in recent games last season. Perhaps you could be next at the next Lambton Lions home game here again tomorrow afternoon against the Mohawk Mountaineers. Darius Canty is going to visit the scorekeeper's table. He is going to check back in. We'll see who it is that will take a seat for the Lions. And after all that, they are going to rule technical against the Knights by the looks of it, and DeAndre Reed will set up at the line. First one rolls out for DeAndre Reed. Goodness, feel bad for our game day staff there. We're running out of songs to play. I'd like to have a no-repeat game day, but we were running out of options. Second one will rattle in for DeAndre Reed, and we'll get back into it in a second here. Tyvel Peters is going to inbound it. On the floor now for the Lambton Lions, number one Tyvel Peters, 7 Journey Joseph, 42 Jason Watts, 21 Carden Edwards, and number 22 DeAndre Reed. That is your starting five tonight. With the exception of Journey Joseph, Cam David, the rookie. And the starting presence for the Lions as the long three will miss 14 seconds. The shot clock will reset for Lambton here. Carden Edwards has it out near half court. Hand off to Jason Watts. There's Journey Joseph open in the corner. The pass a little too high for him. Jason Watts, the three a little short. Outlet pass now to Laquan Hilton. Contested against Tyvel Peters, who cannot understand where the foul call came from. He's got some words for the officiating staff. He's got some words for Hilton as well. Laquan Hilton, great first half as he put up 16 points to go along with 3 rebounds. 4 for 7 from 3. We'll see how he does from the free throw line here. That one will go as well. Journey Joseph has it at half court now, handing it back to DeAndre Reed, to Tyvel Peters. The pace of play starting to pick up a little bit here. Lambton playing with a little bit of urgency there as Journey Joseph will hit the baseline jumper. As the Lions want to maintain momentum, they don't want to give the Knights an opportunity to get back into this one. As the lead is extended to 19, back to 17. As the roll goes in for Johnny Richardson, the third-year guard out of Niagara Falls. Cross-court pass to Tyvel Peters. Carden Edwards has it back at the half. He'll walk it in. Tyvel Peters in the corner, handing it off to Jason Watts. Back out to DeAndre Reed, had an opening there, and he'll float one in from near the free throw line. Seems to have calmed down a little bit there as Johnny Richardson will get in there for 2. Reed not playing with the same grimace on his face that he did a few minutes ago. Perhaps the pep talk over at the sideline helped. Pass goes under the hands of Jason Watts, rolls out of bounds. It is Knights ball. 3:10 to go to 79-62. Lambton leading Niagara here in OCAA men's basketball action. One of 11 home games this regular season here for the Lambton Lions. Versus only 9 road games, the reason being as Laquan Hilton hits the 3 for the Knights. As Sioux College will come down here for a pair of games, and usually they alternate years where Lambton will go up to the Sioux for a pair next year. As a result, only getting 9 home games. DeAndre Reed misses. Why is he shooting? DeAndre Reed getting the ball back here at a fresh shot clock. Making amends for the missed shot just a second ago. Carden Edwards trying to find an opening. Jason Watts pulls up at the free throw line. That rattles in and out. And back come the Knights here, 79-65. They're going to have to start playing with some urgency here. 2:15 to go as Johnny Richardson rolls it in. The third-year guard, a big second-half contributor. Tyvel Peters off the glass, can't finish. He's showing some visible signs of frustration there as Laquan Hilton pulls up for three. That won't go. There is Augustin for the putback. And it looks like the Lions are going to call timeout. Try and regroup defensively here a little bit as the deficit for the Knights has been cut to 10. It was as high as 19 a little more than 2 minutes ago by the looks of it. But now it is 79-69. Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights here.
Everybody clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands.
Before the game, having a chance to chat with veteran Jason Watts, he said that this was the first time going into the start of the season that he was not nervous. He was comfortable. He felt good about his game. He felt good about his teammates. No nerves whatsoever. I don't know if the same can be said for the rest of the squad, as they just do not have the experience that he does. He's the only fifth-year player on the team, so they're going to rely on him perhaps to say some words of encouragement as we head into this final crucial moment here in the fourth quarter. I don't want to say the Lions can rest easy with a 10-point lead, because that could evaporate in a matter of seconds in the game of basketball, but things are not as bad as they could be, that's for sure. The Lions well on their way to opening their season with a W. There's that veteran presence, Jason Watts on the floor, along with Carden Edwards, Tyvell Peters, and the pair of rookies, highly touted, Darius Canty, number 12, and Cam David, number 6. And speaking with the coaching staff, I don't think they have ever been more excited for a pair of players to make their debut than they have about these two, Cam David and Darius Canty. Both on the floor now in this pivotal moment here in the fourth quarter. Minute 45 to go, Lions lead by 10. 8 to go on the shot clock. Carden Edwards has it near half court. Looking for the screen. He gets it opening. Cam David has it in the corner. He'll go baseline and feeds Jason Watts. They're going to say he beat the shot clock. Lead is now 12. About 85 seconds to go here. Long two will miss from Richardson. Rolls out of bounds, and they are going to rule Lions ball. And a very animated head coach, James Grant, on the sideline looking for a very specific play, wanting to maintain control here in these late seconds of the fourth. Cam David. Cam David looking to work his way around. He keeps it in bounds. Almost lost it there. Carden Edwards will bring it back in. Mid-range rattles out. David gets a hold of it again. Another 14 seconds on the shot clock for the Lions. David muscles his way in. Canty is fouled as he goes up for that ball. And Cam David still on the floor over at the baseline, but he'll be pulled up by teammate Jason Watts. Seems to be okay, might be a little foggy after that one. He'll gonna see if he stays on the floor or not. By the looks of it, he will. And a timeout is going to be taken here. 81-69, Lambton Lions lead the Niagara Knights. Just can't sit, gotta get jiggy with it. That's it, the honey, honey, come ride. I want to thank you to those who are watching this evening on a variety of live options here for the first time. LCLions.ca/live. You can watch select games there as well on your TV. And we want to give a big thank you to that production crew for making their way and helping us out and setting this up for the season here, as quite the investment of time and resources put into trying to put on a good broadcast for you, and we certainly thank you for tuning in, and we hope we can please all season long. That's what we aim for here. And we certainly appreciate you tuning in. We appreciate the fans that show up here in person and cheer on the Lions and just support OCAA men's basketball. That's what it's all about in the end. Regardless of what team you're rooting for, we certainly appreciate your viewership here this evening. From myself and the entire staff here at Lambton College. As the rookie Darius Canty out of Ecorse, Michigan, will set up at the line. 58 and a half to go on the clock. Lions leading by 12. As number 12 will miss the first one. Couple of taps of encouragement from his teammates. Darius Canty hits the second one. Certainly one to look out for as a contender for Rookie of the Year as this season goes on. Same goes for Cam David, number 6 for the Lambton Lions. Still on the floor as the 3 will miss for Lacoli. Back comes Cam David. That's what we're talking about on the fast break, number 6. Outlet pass for Hilton, mishandled, and back into the hands of number 22, Stefan Augustin. Gets the and one here. Number 1 and number 2 coming back in for the Lambton Lions. It's Tyvell Peters and rookie Tyrell Miller. Number 2, the 5'10" guard out of Brampton, Ontario. As Augustin can't finish the and one, but the rebound pulled down by Lacoli. 30 seconds to go on the clock, and the big block by the Hungarian Dennis Hegedus. Bringing the volume up here at the Lions Den, and with good reason. Knights looking for another opportunity to just chip into that deficit, try and make it at least a single digit deficit here, 84-73, so they're still down 11. Pass is picked off. Hilton with the handoff to Augustin. He'll float one in, and the deficit cut to 9. Augustin saying, where's the foul call, but he won't get it. 13 seconds to go, and the Knights putting on a full press here, but all for naught as the clock winds down. The bench stands up. The applause begins, and the Lambton Lions start their season with the victory in what is sure to be an historic season for the Lions as they make their way towards hosting the OCAA championship this March. They start off on the right foot with an 84-75 victory over the visiting Niagara Knights here at Lambton College. Join us tomorrow again as the Mohawk Mountaineers come to town to take on the 1-0. Now we can say Lambton Lions and Niagara Knights on their way to take on the St. Clair Saints tomorrow afternoon in Windsor. I'm Tony Frangis. Thank you for watching OCAA Men's Basketball. We'll see you next time. My verse will still be serving.